July 14, 2005, and we're interviewing Dr. George Mitchell. My name is Nancy Claypool, and we'll start out by asking Dr. Mitchell just to give us your name and tell us a little bit about some of the food businesses and establishments in Marshall.
Well, I'm Dr. George Mitchell, and I remember back, particularly back in the 1920s, different food establishments, grocery stores, meat markets, restaurants that were located here in Marshall during that period of time. It started on the Courthouse Square, on the southwest corner of the square at 5th and, we call it Main Street in those days, it's Archer Avenue now. There was a grocery on the corner there, on the southwest corner, that was run by a man by the name of Nick Daniel. They carried a full line of groceries, and later the man by the name of Sowers operated that. And you go around the square, on the south side of the square, there's Lichtenberger's. It's located where the Joe Schroeder's law office is right now. And Mr. Lichtenberger operated that store there for a number of years. His family were all involved. His children, they all worked there. Later, he moved the store over on the Main Street where the Mexican restaurant is at the present time. Also on the west of the east side of the square was Rademacher's bottling plant where they manufactured soft drinks. On down Main Street, well, coming back a little ways from where Lichtenberger's was located, was a restaurant operated by people of the name of Hornbrook. It was a Busy Bee Cafe. That's where Nancy's Gallery is at the present time. You go on down Main Street, there was the Archer House Hotel, which is still there. And they at one time served food there. Then you go across the street, Main Street, on the corner of Route 1 and Main Street, was a man by the name of John Mullins operated the Keystone Cafe. And then coming back to the west was the Al Cafe, which is located, there's a restaurant in there at the present time. And that was operated by I think you upgraded that one. That's Tom Crump. And Tom was quite a jokester. And he had a whole showcase full of jokes that you could play on people, like exploding cigars and cigarettes. And then he was always playing jokes on people. And one time, he found a cat, and he poured some turpentine on that cat, and it took off running, ran to the police station next door, and Tom was chasing it all the way through. Then coming back up to the west was a grocery store operated by people in the name of Whelan, and that's right next to the City Hall. Then you come on back west, was a grocery store on the corner where the Chinese restaurant is now. That was operated by Ben Baird. And later, it was operated by a man by the name of Hanley. Then they came, came on west, and there was a bakery. It was operated by C.R. Johnson. Golden Crest Bread was, and he had quite a business. And he used to ship bread to other towns in the area by train early in the morning. And then there was a restaurant operated there just next to the bakery. Our maiden name was Hennig. It was Nell's Cafe. And later, Ray Buechler operated that. And then you come on west a little further, and there was another grocery store, and it was Oakley's, which was the first chain store in Marshall, chain grocery. Then you come on west a little further, and across 6th Street, and on the north side was Dahl's Grocery, and it was operated by Louis Dahl. His father started the store. His name was D.D. Dahl, and that store was in business for almost 100 years. And Mr. Dahl, Louis Dahl, finally closed the store when the World War II came along, because they had to deal with food stamps, and he didn't want to do all the paperwork, so he made enough money he could retire. Then he came on a little further west, and Mealing's grocery store was located there. And that was operated by, well, his son now is Bill Mealing. And then there was down on the corner of 5th and Main Street, on the northwest corner, was Moy's Grocery. And I worked there as a kid when I was 13 or 14 years old. Worked every Saturday. I went to work at 6:30 in the morning and got off about midnight, because we had all the farmers coming in with their produce, and they'd trade the produce for chickens. They trade their chickens and eggs and cream for groceries. And in the summertime, I worked 6 days a week. And I made $1.50 on a Saturday, and during the week, I got $10 for 6 days. And there was a lot of work there. That was one job I never did like. But coming back over on the courthouse square, the Marshall House Hotel sat on the corner of 6th and Locust. It's a vacant lot now. And they had a dining room and served delicious meals there. It was quite a place. And the north edge of Marshall, up where they crossed the railroad tracks on the Clarksville Road, was the cheese factory, Kraft Cheese factory, and the farmers brought their milk in there, and then they processed it into cheese. And I was working on the farm then, and I just had to bring all the milk in early in the morning, and then I'd get cans of whey and take back the feed to the hogs. So, but that's a little bit about the food industry in Marshall, as I remember.
How do you think the availability and the types and just the way people enjoy food has changed?
Well, it's been quite a change. Back in those days, it was just pretty simple. We had, I remember I ate an awful lot of ham when I was a kid. Smoked ham, mashed potatoes, gravy, sweet potatoes. We didn't go much for salads, maybe coleslaw, but there wasn't much thought given to what was healthy and what wasn't healthy. Everybody ate pretty hearty meals. And when you sat down at the table, you had a table full of food. And but today you have a lot of health concerns and a lot of health foods, and salads and such. that we didn't used to have back then. And so there's been quite a change.
What about the way people go out to dinner a lot and the way, tell about how people used to go a lot to the cafes and eat a lot of their meals there and how the kids used the establishment?
Well, people didn't go out much to eat back in those days. I mean, they would, of course, people that were working around, and a lot of times would eat lunch. We didn't call it lunch, and it was dinner. And the food was hearty, but it wasn't fancy. And it's very seldom people really went out to dinner at a restaurant. It had to be a special occasion. Nowadays, people go out to eat every night. Most every night, you'll see different people. You go out to eat, you'll see the same people that are eating. So a lot of people eating out today that we didn't used to have, you eat at home.
Was Marshall known for anything in particular in food?
Any what?
Was Marshall known for any type of food in particular, or any particular places were particularly popular?
No, they didn't have any special food. John Mullen, who operated the Keystone Cafe, developed a sauce dressing, and it's still being sold. Mullen's salad dressing.
In Palestine?
I think it's still available. Of course, he's been long gone. But Tom Kasempis worked for John Mullen as a night cook, and he'd been with the Candy Kitchen before that with George and Pete Helicos, two other Greeks. And he married a local girl, and my dad lived with all the kids, and there was a restaurant for present Tom, there's a Femic restaurant is now. It was operated by another man, and he sold out, or wanted to sell out, and get out of the restaurant business, and my father and my uncle owned the building, so they were interested in getting another person in there to operate the restaurant. So my dad talked to Tom, who was a good friend, and told him, he said, I want you to buy that restaurant. And Tom said, well, he said, I couldn't. He said, I don't have the money. Well, he had a big family, and he's working a night shift down there at the restaurant all by himself. And he had a heck of a business. And he'd worked from 7 at night till 7 the next morning by himself. And he did all the cooking, waited the tables, washed the dishes, and I don't think he was making very much. So my dad convinced him that he could operate this restaurant. And my dad was, at that time, was president of one of the local banks. And they loaned him the money, and Tom paid that off in 1 year. And he was a great success. I've seen people stand in line on the sidewalk on Sunday dinner, waiting to get into the restaurant. So that's what he ended up doing. So Tom has been here for years and years and years now, and was taken over and operated by his son after he died, and is still in business with another owner. So that's how that happened.
That's interesting. Well, I think that takes care of our interview. Thank you very much.
Okay.
We appreciate it.
I hope I did all right.